My name is Bobby Clark, and I'm an artist and photographer working in Melbourne. From everywhere. I think it's really hard to pinpoint where inspiration comes from. For shapes, I look at architecture and interiors a lot. I try not to look at other art because I might get influenced too much. I'm inspired by my husband, who's a sculptor. Everything and anywhere. It could be an exhibition, it could be just going for a walk and seeing something in a shop window. I'm constantly getting ideas all the time. I've always been an artist. I grew up in a house full of artists. So my gran, my mum, my aunt, my grandpa, he was an oil painter. So I spent my whole childhood squeezing oil paints out of tubes. My gran would set up still lifes on our kitchen table for me. My mum, we'd have like a little night, I'd put on all her jewellery and she'd like put lipstick on me and draw my portrait. I kind of never really thought about doing it as a career because when you grow up, everyone's always like, you can't be an artist. That's not a job. So I thought it was always going to be a hobby. I just stripped it right back. I watched a documentary on Picasso and how he mastered like Renaissance painting in this like hyper-realist kind of style of oil painting. And once he'd mastered it, he's like, now what? He stripped it right back and went primal and went back to basics. So that's what I done. I went back to just simple mark making, like getting paint and actually just putting shapes on paper. And that's kind of how this stuff happened, was just painting because I wanted to. And I think obviously like Australian landscape, I mean, the natural stone and the red dirt over here, I mean, couch clearly. I've just always loved a kind of simple, earthy, muted palette. So like olive greens, deep navies, terracotta, sand. They're just something that's never gonna come in and out of fashion. It's never a trend. It's just like a color palette for life. That we have emotions. And it's not a downfall, it's like we can apply that kind of tactile, more sensitive side to design and the workplace. That's a real positive to being a woman. I think by nature women have a lot of strength because if we want something, we really have to go for it. I will not be told I cannot lift something because I'm a fucking woman. I'm like, no, no, thanks, I've got it, I can do it. It's just made me really determined. So I think if you just figure out your core values and what you like, I think that's really important to work that out. What makes you happy, eventually your thing will come. I think there's such an emphasis on finding it, it actually can stop people from discovering what it is. I've worked since I was 13 as well. My first job was licking envelopes and cleaning the toilets. That's the thing as well, like never thinking you're too good, being able to clean the toilets. I'm never too proud to do the dirty jobs, ever. I'm a total homebody. Creating a space with all your things is probably the closest thing to yourself you'll get because it's your safest place.